be better.
And now a word from our sponsor, Braniff International.
Braniff International hostess meets you on the airplane, she'll be dressed like this. When she brings you your dinner, she'll be dressed this way. After dinner on those long flights, slip into something a little more comfortable. The Airstrip is brought to you by Braniff International, who believes that even an airline hostess should look like a girl.
It is now my esteemed pleasure to introduce Ben Cass.
Good evening. My name is Ben Cass. I'm president of Braniff Airways Foundation and chairman of Braniff International. I want to welcome you to our Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame induction ceremony. This is our first virtual induction and our sixth induction of Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame inductees. The Hall of Fame induction was started in 2014 to honor important Braniff Airways family members. The first one was John Allen Pierce, who was the architect that constructed the jet rail terminal at Dallas Love Field and the Hostess College on Wycliffe Avenue here in Dallas. Braniff President Harding L. Lawrence removed the nepotism policy from Braniff's records in 1966, and with that he actually brought forward the real beginning of the Braniff family moniker. It's a very close-knit group of employees that have stayed close and worked together all of these years to ensure that Braniff is not forgotten and always remembered. Tonight we will induct six new Braniff family inductees. Our first is Mrs. Elizabeth Shepherd from Reservations, Mr. Joe Mitchell, manager of charter operations, and posthumously Mrs. Patricia Greer Harris, flight attendant. Also, Mrs. Kathy Logan Smith, flight attendant. And posthumously, Mr. Lawrence Lyle Eberly, a flight dispatcher. And finally, Mrs. Marilyn Bowling, manager of revenue accounting. Our selection process begins in the spring when we ask for nominations for the Hall of Fame. Then in the summer and fall, we begin reviewing these with our board of directors. And then later in the fall, we finally make the selection of generally three, sometimes anywhere from one to three selectees. And then we announce this at our annual Braniff Christmas party every year. Unfortunately, due to the COVID-19 pandemic this year, we had to delay last year's 2019 inductees, or 2020 inductees, and 2021 until this year. And so this year we're inducting all six from the last 2 years. And now our first inductee is Mrs. Elizabeth Shepherd, who worked in reservations, mainly in the Houston, Texas, and Dallas areas.
We better be better. We better be better. We're Braniff.
want to thank Braniff Airways Foundation for inducting me into its Braniff Hall of Fame and for giving me a beautiful plaque to commemorate that. The plaque says, Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame, Elizabeth Ann Shepherd, Reservations Agent, has been inducted into the Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame on June 27, 2021. This award is presented to you in honor of your unprecedented dedication to the preservation of the history and legacy of Braniff Airways and for your years of dedicated service to Braniff International and the airline industry. Braniff Airways Foundation, Dallas, Texas. I worked over 9 years in the reservations department of Braniff and then sold Braniff t-shirts and memorabilia for about 34 years. I did whatever I could to give Braniff and its employees support when needed. I also encouraged the former employees to stay in contact with one another via address lists, Facebook pages, and the Braniff Retirement Club. I want to thank some folks who have helped me over the years sell my Braniff t-shirts and memorabilia. My son Jack Russell, Janie Hilliard, Kay Guerrero, and Gene Jordan. I thank Art Frederick for getting me started with selling the very attractive Braniff logo items which he printed, and later Bryant Pettit and his t-shirt business, skyshirts.com, which supplied me with outstanding Braniff t-shirts for many years. Lastly, I thank Ben Cash for buying my little Braniff t-shirt business several years ago to merge with his much larger Braniff logo collection, BraniffBoutique.com, which offers quite a variety of wonderful Braniff items. I'd like to take this opportunity to encourage all former Braniff employees to join the Braniff Retirement Club Facebook page so that you may become reconnected to some of your former co-workers. In September, our Braniff Retirement Club monthly luncheons will resume, and then we will have our special Christmas luncheon at the Frontiers of Flight Museum in Dallas on Sunday, December 5th. In an effort to stay connected, former Braniff flight attendants are encouraged to join a Facebook page called Braniff Clip Bees, which Gene Jordan, president of that organization, has created. We have a major event to look forward to next year in 2022, the opening of a 75-room Braniff Hotel located on Wycliffe Avenue near the Dallas North Tollway, which was Braniff's former hostess college for a number of years. The developer who is doing the transformation is the one who restored the Statler Hotel in downtown Dallas several years ago. Again, I want to thank the Braniff Airways Foundation for this special honor it has bestowed upon me. I appreciate it very much.
Thank you, Chloe Wareham Gordon, for that wonderful video tribute of Mrs. Shepherd. And thank you, Elizabeth Shepherd and family, for that wonderful speech and discussion about your induction. Now I would like to introduce Mr. Brad Ackland, a singer who has been with us many times here at Braniff.
This next song is a beautiful song by Tony Bennett. I get requested this song quite a bit. The loveliness of Paris seems somehow sadly gay. The glory that was Rome is of another day. I've been terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my heart in San Francisco. High on a hill, it calls to me to be well, little cable car. Climb halfway to the stars. The morning fog made to the end. I don't care, my love waits there. In San Francisco, above the blue and windy sea, when I come home to you, San Francisco, your golden sun will shine for me.
And our second inductee is Mr. Joe Mitchell, Manager of Charter Operations.
We promise to give every Braniff passenger the finest airline service.
My name is Joe Mitchell, and I started with Braniff down in Brownsville, May 2nd, 1966, as a customer service agent. I was with Braniff for 32 years, ending with Braniff number 2 in September of 1998. Also, I was one of the last 5 employees of Braniff number 2. I almost turned the job down with Braniff because of 2 reasons. One being, after my interview at Exchange Park, I boarded a flight back to Brownsville with a stop in San Antonio. In San Antonio, agent came on board the flight and asked all non-revenue passengers to deplane. Well, I stayed in my seat. I didn't know what a non-rev passenger was. Later on, he stormed back on the aircraft, came to my seat, wanted to see my ticket. He said, "You're a non-rev. You need to get off." I said, "But I've got to be back in Brownsville for my job in the morning." He said, "All I can tell you, you see the agent inside. Our flight is oversold." I said, "Thank you." So I went inside, talked to the agent, told him and explained everything. He said, "Well, the bus station's downtown. That's what I recommend you do." So I left. Went to the bus station, and I'm thinking on the way, do I want to go to work for this company or not? I wasn't sure. Anyway, I made it back to Brownsville the next morning in time to go to work. The second reason, I found out that this job was shift work. Later on, I handed my special envelope to Mr. Roy Davis, the station manager in Brownsville. He told me I was hired. When would I like to start? I said, "Well, how about let me give 2 weeks' notice to the company I work for, and then I'll be ready to go about 2 weeks on a Monday." He said, "No." He said, "That's not the way it works." He said, "This is going to be shift work with morning shifts, afternoon shifts, different days off." I said, "Oh." He said, "I have to bid the shifts, and since you'll be the bottom of the seniority list, you'll end up with whatever is left." I'm not sure about this. I like my weekends off. He said, "Well, think about it and let me know tomorrow, because if you don't take it, I've got to go find somebody else." I said, "Okay." So I thought about it. and decided I'll go on and try it. So I called him back the next day and said, Mr. Davis, I'll take the job. He said, fine. Said, I'll bid the shifts and I'll let you know what you end up with. I said, okay. So after about 2 weeks, he called me and said, I've got good news and bad news for you. I said, oh, what's the good news? He said, well, the good news, you got Sundays and Mondays off. That's part of a weekend. I said, that's not too bad. He said, the bad news, you're going to have to open the station at 0430 every morning for the 0600 departure. And I'm saying, okay, I'll do it. So anyway, but I did live, and I did that for 2 years before I transferred to Dallas in May of 1968. I really enjoyed my 32 years with Braniff, working with some of the best people on this earth. Every day was different and never boring. I have many great memories of my life with Braniff 1 and Braniff 2 that I'll never forget. In closing, I would like to thank the Braniff Foundation and their board of directors for this honor of being selected to the Braniff Wall of Honor, along with the other selectees and previous selectees. Thank you again, and remember to always fly Braniff.
Let me congratulate Joe Mitchell and his family for his induction into the Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame. And now we're going to see a quick video about our current restoration project of the Braniff, original Braniff Concorde SST. This is actually the one that was painted in the on the right side in the British Airways colors. We're doing a slight moderate restoration on this, and it will be on view soon at Frontiers of Flight Museum here in Dallas.
Hey everyone, we're at a little bit different venue today. We're at Frontiers of Flight Museum at Dallas Love Field, where we do our exhibiting. We're in the Braniff Gallery here. We have another gallery across the way over there that you probably remember. As you see way over there, it has some of our larger models in it. I'll get it for you. There they are, including the all three South American jetliners that we used. But today, we're over here taking down the original 1/20th scale Concorde. And you may remember that last year, 2 years ago, we actually had the sister one, which was the Air France Concorde, redone in the had to be restored in the Braniff Heritage color scheme on both sides. But this sister model is British Airways, and it is still in that. So there is that color scheme. So these models were used for all the promo for our January 1979 Concorde inauguration. And this model is being taken down to have some light restoration and rework. And it will be nicely polished. There needs to be some work on the bottom. It was starting to decay on the stand. There you can see this heavy metal stand it's on. It was starting to slightly decay and cave off to the left. It had been up on the wall here, the big orange wall. But as you can see, it's in pretty good condition, especially for a 40-year-old plus model. So that's what we're doing today at Braniff.
And now I'd like to present our third inductee of the Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame, Mrs. Patricia Greer Harris, who is being inducted posthumously.
I'm Cody Greer Harris. I am Patricia Greer Harris's son, and received this notification that my mom was inducted to the Braniff Hall of Fame. That is awesome. My mom, being a Braniff flight attendant, part of the Braniff community, was a huge part of her personality, her identity, and I'm really blessed to. Got to hear all the glory days stories and just what made Braniff kind of a special organization compared to what most people might realize in a commercial airliner, right? So I know, she would be just over the moon thrilled with this, and it'd be something that she would just be super proud of. When she towards the end, when her memory was getting a little bit spotty, especially for short term stuff, you know, the stuff that always rang clear was all of the old Braniff stuff. So, on behalf of me, my dad, my family, and my mom, thank you guys very much. And it makes us very happy. And I know it would make my mom very happy that you guys are putting so much effort into keeping the Braniff spirit alive. So thank you very much.
I would like to congratulate the Harris family for their induction of of Pat Harris, a flight attendant with Braniff Airways for many years and a very good friend of mine.
Next up is a short piece performed by me. To Danny Boy, performed by Brad Auckland. It is dedicated to all past and current Hall of Fame inductees, as well as to my dad, George Stanley Gordon, the late Braniff ad exec and proud Irish American.
Oh, Danny Boy. The pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. 'Tis I'll be in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. And if you come when all the flowers are dying and I am dead as dead I well may be, you'll come and find the place where I am lying and kneel and say, and are they there for me? And I shall hear though soft your tread above me. And all my dreams will all the sweeter be. And you shall pay and tell me that you love me. And I shall sleep in peace until you come to me.
And now a word from our sponsor, Braniff International.
Ladies and gentlemen, Braniff International welcomes you aboard flight 930. Last year, Braniff International completely redesigned its airline. And we wondered if people would like it. Now, we wonder if people like it a little too much. Oh, we're not against souvenir hunting. So long as it doesn't get out of hand.
And our fourth recipient is Mrs. Kathy Logan Smith, flight attendant for many years with Braniff Airways, a good friend of mine. And this is someone who also works very hard with the Clip Bees, the Braniff Flight Attendant, Retired Flight Attendant Association. She does their newsletter called the Buzz Notes. So she does a lot of work. She's had a great career with Braniff and time in ensuring that Braniff is kept for future generations.
Hi, my name's Colby Logan.
And I'm Kevin Logan.
Our mother, Kathy Logan Smith, was a Braniff flight attendant from 1969 to 1974, and we are extremely proud to present our mother with a very special award.
To honor her unprecedented dedication to the preservation, history, and legacy of Braniff, our mother has been inducted into the Braniff Airways Hall of Fame. Her service to Braniff continued beyond her active employee days as she became active in the Braniff Clip Bees, volunteer work at the Braniff headquarters, and her service to the Braniff Airways Foundations.
Currently, she's the publisher and editor of the Clip Bees newsletter, Buzz Notes, and is starting her sixth year in that role. And she's also served as secretary and first vice president. So, congratulations.
Congratulations, Mom.
Here you go.
Well, thanks, Kevin and Colby. And a huge thank you to Ben Cass and the Braniff Foundation for this honor. I feel like there are so many others who are much more deserving than I am, but hey, I'll take it. It has definitely been my pleasure and good fortune to be involved with Braniff and the Clip Bees, and it has been so much fun maintaining this special group of friends all these years. I will never, ever forget my flying days with Braniff. Hey, come to think of it, there are so many songs that when I hear them on the radio, the oldie stations, takes me right back to those fun days. Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head from Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, and who could forget Leaving on a Jet Plane. To Braniff and the Braniff family, thanks for the memories.
'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane, don't know when I'll be back again. Oh babe, I hate to go, 'cause I'm leaving on a jet plane, don't know when I'll be back again. Oh babe, I hate to go, 'cause I'm leaving on.
And congratulations to Kathy Logan Smith and her wonderful family for this acceptance of this award. You may see that I'm sitting here in our Braniff 747 concept cabin project, which has been ongoing since last year. We want to thank the Humanities of Texas for their generous grant, as well as the Eugene McDermott Foundation for ensuring that this project has moved forward. So now let's watch a quick video about this so you can see where we are on this unique exhibit.
Hey everyone, back working on the Braniff 747 concept cabin today. I don't know how many people would have a aircraft wall panel jig in their house, but that's kind of what we've created here with books and with I think a couple of noodles boxes on the other end here. But what we've got, this is your wall panels that the main interior wall panels will connect to, that we've cut out and been working on. What we did, we wetted these down, then put the panel on it, mounted it to it like it would be on the aircraft. We have not bolted it in at the bottom. That will happen once it's put in. Then we clamp this down all the way through, let this fully dry for a day on the four that we're going to use. And we got this great little curvature here. There will actually be a system in the back that this will actually attach to, and then back to the main system as well of supports, the metal supports that you'll see. And that's going to be our next project. So this is coming out pretty well.
And let me introduce to you Mr. Lawrence Lyle Eberly, who is a flight dispatcher for Braniff Airways. He is being inducted posthumously today into the Hall of Fame. His daughter, Donna Jordan, will do his tribute video.
We were so excited to hear Daddy's name mentioned at the end of the first virtual Braniff Christmas show that premiered on December 20th, 2020. Thanks to the Braniff Foundation and President Ben Cass for honoring Lawrence Lyle Eberly, posthumous induction into the Braniff Hall of Fame. Congratulations to all fellow Hall of Famers for this year, Joe Mitchell, manager, charter operations, Kathy Logan Smith and Patricia Greer Harris, posthumous, both flight attendants, Elizabeth Shepherd, reservations, and Marilyn Bowling, manager, revenue management. The Braniff employees displayed such camaraderie, and each employee felt it a privilege to work for Braniff, truly a family. Daddy started his career at Braniff within 5 weeks of being honorably discharged from the U.S. Air Force in 1943. Braniff at the time had 18 DC-3s. In 1945, along with his wife, Aline, they moved to Denver, Colorado to work as station manager at Stapleton Airport and welcomed their first child, Stephen, in 1946. That same year, the Civil Aeronautics Board awarded Braniff routes to the Caribbean, Central, and South America. In 1947, Mr. Braniff purchased 10 DC-6s. This aircraft, with a pressurized cabin, cruising altitude of 20,000 feet, plus the Pratt Whitney engines, was instrumental in introducing flying to the general public. Mr. Braniff had sleeping berths installed in the ceiling. In 1950, Daddy and his family moved to Lima, Peru, to begin his work as station manager at Lima Tombo Airport, a new country and a new language to learn. In 1951, the family moved to Buenos Aires, Argentina, to begin his work as station manager at Ezeiza International Airport that had opened in 1945. It was the third largest airport in the world at the time. The sleeping berth that Mr. Braniff had installed on the DC-6s made it a lot easier to fly the 30 hours to Buenos Aires. In 1952, the family welcomed their twin daughters, Gail and myself, Donna, born in Buenos Aires. In 1955, Daddy and his family moved to Dallas, Texas, Love Field, to begin his job as flight dispatcher. Aline joined the Thursday Nighters, an organization with fellow Braniff wives that rolled bandages for Parkland Hospital. The family had the travel bug, and many trips were taken during the next 20 years. Daddy passed away in 1978, the year of the Deregulation Act, which opened up the free market in the commercial airline industry. He absolutely loved his job of 35 years, the camaraderie, and the sense of family with his fellow employees. Thank you again for recognizing Lawrence Lyle Eberly for his dedication to his career at Braniff, and while at the same time perpetuating Braniff's and Daddy's legacy. Thank you again.
Many thanks to the Jordan family for the acceptance of this Hall of Fame award. And now our sixth and final recipient is Miss Marilyn Bowling, a very close friend of ours. She was the manager of revenue accounting at Braniff and has spent many of her retired years of ensuring that Braniff's legacy continues forward and is not forgotten.
Everybody's talking about Braniff.
Hello, my name is Marilyn Bowling, and the man behind me is Rudy. I'm here today to accept the very special Braniff Foundation Hall of Fame plaque. I worked for Braniff and Braniff II from 1958 to 1987 in various positions and cities. I'm appreciative and very happy to be recognized as a forever Braniff employee and supporter. I loved being a part of the preservation of the maintenance base at 7701 Lemon Avenue, where I began my career at Braniff. And subsequently, in the later positions that I've held, none have meant more to me than Braniff, where I was the happiest to work. Through Braniff, I met my wonderful husband of 44 years, Rudy Bowling. We are both proud to have worked at Braniff and to be connected today with the Braniff Retirement Club and the Braniff Foundation. If I worked with you at any time in the past, I want to thank you for your friendship and for your assistance in making me look so good. Thank you, and thanks again for this honor.
Congratulations to Marilyn Bowling for acceptance of the Hall of Fame award. And now I'd like to introduce our graphic artist here at Braniff International, Mr. Carlos Udica.
I'm Carlos Udica. I'm a graphic artist with Braniff International. We're working on a brand new line of t-shirts and a bunch of other products that will display the beautiful logos and designs of Braniff. Right now, what you see on my screen is a beautiful DC8 two-tone red over tan. This design is going to be applied to one of our products, and it will be available through the stores and the Braniff boutique very shortly. Stay tuned, and thank you.
Udica.
Hello, my name is Chloe Wareham Gordon, and I'm a grant writer and social media manager for Braniff Airways Foundation. My father, George Stanley Gordon, was an advertising exec who approached Alexander Calder with this idea of having him paint a commercial jet. And that idea transpired and became Braniff's hugely successful Flying Colors of the U.S. advertising campaign. Subsequently, my dad stayed on at Braniff as an ad exec and was behind such memorable slogans as "Better, Be Better, We're Braniff." Presently, the foundation is working on a lot of exciting new grant opportunities, and we're increasing our engagement and reach on social media. We're also reaching younger audiences and educating them on how transformative and revolutionary of an airline Braniff was and the power the name still has today. I'm so grateful that I'm able to do this work for the foundation and keep not only my father's legacy alive, but the legacies of thousands of remarkable Braniff employees.
And here's another piece by Brad Auckland.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying hi. apparently said, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are so other faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a
I hope you've enjoyed our show this evening. I want to thank again personally each of the six recipients of the 2020 and 2021 Braniff Airways Foundation Hall of Fame Award. On December 5th, which is a Sunday, 2021, beginning at 11 a.m., we will hold our annual Braniff Christmas Party at the Frontiers of Flight Museum at Dallas Love Field. At this event, we will acknowledge each of the award recipients and their families at a special ceremony that day. To learn more about Braniff, contact us at BraniffInternational.com and for, of course, the latest in Braniff products, BraniffBoutique.com. Again, thank you for joining us and have a good evening.
America, look how far you've come. 200 years, America, look up, there's a future to be won. That's why Braniff is flying your colors. Braniff is painting your sky.
Braniff Promise.
We promise to knock ourselves out to be the world's friendliest, most professional airline personnel.
We promise to provide frequent schedules throughout the U.S. and to Europe, Asia, Mexico, South America.
We promise to do everything we can to run an on-time airline.
We promise to provide quick, accurate ticket purchase and check-in.
We promise to handle your bags with care and deliver them promptly.
We promise to serve some of the best food you've ever eaten on any airline.
We promise to fly young, beautifully decorated airplanes.
We promise to fly meticulously maintained airplanes.
We promise to answer our phones and provide information promptly.
We promise to offer bargain vacation fares to every brand of city.
We hereby promise to make every effort to give the best airline service in the world. And when you make promises like these, you better be better.
They're young, they're beautiful, and they're so clean, so attractively dressed. It's a pleasure to go places with them. Such energy, such vitality. Distance means nothing to them. The country, the world is theirs. They're on the go, all day, every day. Whenever you turn around, they're taking off for somewhere. They're young, they're beautiful. They're Braniff 747s and 727s, among the newest, most beautiful fleets in the airline industry, because Braniff promises to do everything possible to give you the best airline service in the world.
We better be better.
Our name is Braniff, and we fly to over 50 major cities in the U.S., 9 countries in South America, Mexico, principal capitals in Europe, major cities in the Pacific, and the Far East. And to every one of them, we promise to do everything we can to give you the best airline service in the world.
We won't rest until you say that
Braniff is the best in all the world.
When you make promises like we do, you better be better.
We better be better.